Hello, everyone. My name is Cassandra Souza. Thank you for tuning into this book talk. I will be giving you some insight on the book The Revolution of Birdie Randolph, written by Brandy Colbert. It was published by Little Brown and Company in 2019. This young adult fiction novel focuses on Dove Randolph, who goes by the nickname Birdie. Birdie is a high school student who has a bright life and future ahead of her. I would describe Birdie as the perfect daughter because she follows her parents' rules and live up to their high expectations. Except things change when she meets Booker. Booker is Birdie's love interest who has a not-so-welcoming past. Birdie hides their relationship from her family because she knows that he will be judged. He goes to school with Laz, and that's how the couple meets. Laz is Birdie's gay best friend. The two have been friends since they were young, and Birdie can always count on Laz for anything. Laz and Birdie are such good friends because their moms own a hair salon together. Kitty is part owner of the hair salon, but more importantly, she is Birdie's mom. Kitty is a strict parent who can be very judgmental at times, especially to her daughter Birdie and to her own sister Charlene. Charlene is Birdie's aunt who comes into town unexpectedly, and her presence changes the atmosphere at the Randolph residence. Charlene holds a family secret that, if revealed, can change the story. Birdie Randolph is a 16-year-old girl who has her life mapped out every step of the way. The story takes place in present-day Chicago. Birdie's parents are strict and hold her to high standards. Being at the teenage age, Birdie wants to explore life outside of her apartment walls. Birdie tests her boundaries with her parents' rules when Aunt Charlene shows up and moves in with the Randolphs. Things heat up when Booker spends the night at Birdie's when her parents are out of town. A conversation that night leads Birdie to do some investigation, which is when things start to take a turn. As the story continues, Birdie unravels a secret and has to come to terms with the fact that she now knows what her family has been hiding from her. Her so-called perfect life turns upside down, and she is faced with emotions and confusions that she wished she didn't have. The Revolution of Birdie Randolph is a story that hits home because of strong family ties and, more importantly, love. I chose these quotes because I thought they captured the book's themes as well as connections to sociology. I don't know how to say that I'm not ashamed, but we don't openly discuss a lot of things around here. I think being uncomfortable makes my mother feel out of control, on page 55. This first quote I picked just highlights the fact that Birdie's mom has things controlled in a way where Birdie feels like she can't open up to her own mother about how she is feeling. This was something Birdie was struggling with throughout the entire book. I chose this next one specifically because I immediately thought of conversations of our Black woman class. Dr. Davis is a Black woman, which surprises me, and then I feel stupid for being surprised. My father is a Black doctor, but I'm still not used to seeing that, especially women, and it makes me feel more comfortable, on page 248. Birdie was taken back that our doctor was a Black woman because it was simply not common. This is something that has been apparent all throughout the United States. When young boys and girls don't see role models and people of their same race in positions of power, these children become discouraged and oftentimes left with the feeling that they won't amount to anything. This book relates directly to sociology in our class, The Black Woman, in four different ways. Sociology in general is extremely important for understanding and objectively making connections to society. I think the Black woman class gives a great understanding of the struggles and the oppression that Black women in our society face. The first connection I made from the Black woman class to this book was empowerment. Throughout the story, Birdie learns that empowering herself is the best way to succeed. Following paths is not something that will make you achieve your dreams. The second connection I made was a concept of intersectionality. Each character has their own intersectionality story. Take Laz, for example. His experiences are different from Booker's because he identifies as being gay. The overlapping categories changes the experiences that each character has. The third connection has to do with discrimination. There is one scene in the book where this group of friends have a run-in with the police. The color of their skin determines the outcome of the situation. In the Black woman class, we talked a lot about what people assume of you because of the color of your skin, which is why things played out the way that they did. The last connection to the Black woman class was the notion of controlling images. Birdie and Kitty have these images in their mind that they have to be upheld. Our class dug deep into this, and we realized how negative the impact of controlling images can be on a person. if these controlling images of education and life was supposed to look like, the story would have a different ending. I would definitely recommend this book to anyone in high school or in college. I have never been a big fan of reading, but Brandy Colbert does a fantastic job of drawing the reader in and keeping the story alive through each chapter. The twists and turns lead to an outcome that I was not expecting, but I instantly made the connections once I uncovered the family secret. This book will leave you wanting more, and it is definitely worth the read. If you like this book and you want to read more by Brandy Colbert, I would also recommend her book, Little and Lion. Thanks for listening to this book talk. I hope you read and enjoy The Revolution of Birdie Randolph.